Very good evening, everyone. In this particular video, I'm going to talk about a very important topic, and that is how to score 35 plus marks in your finance subject in your RBI Grade B exam. So let's get started. I'm going to tell you a lot of important elements. So please do watch the video till the very end. Now, before I get into the intricacies, let's talk about what is the exam pattern in your phase 2 specifically with respect to finance and management. So finance and management subject aapka hota hai, there are two segments to it. One is the finance segment and the other one is the management segment. And in both these subjects, there are going to be some objective type of questions and there are going to be some descriptive type of questions. Now, let's understand the pattern first. So there are 30 MCQ questions, 30 MCQ questions aapko aate hain, that is including both finance and management, in which there are 20 questions of 2 marks each and there are 10 questions of 1 mark each. This is what is the pattern of MCQ question. If I have to talk about the descriptive questions, in descriptive you have 6 questions where there are 3 questions which are of 15 marks and there are 3 questions which are of 10 marks, out of which you only have to attempt 4 questions. So technically speaking, 2 questions have to be attempted from 15 markers and 2 questions have to be attempted from 10 markers. Approximately, based on the past year paper analysis, approximately the marks is equal in terms of finance and management. That means out of the total 100 marks that you have to attempt, 50 marks are going to belong to your management subject and 50 marks are going to belong to the finance subject. So in this particular video, I'm going to specifically talk about how can you score 35 plus marks in your finance domain. That means out of 50. Now, the first and the foremost thing which I want to emphasize is you have to understand that you have to go through the syllabus very, very thoroughly. Now, why I'm saying this? Because during my classes with the student, what I've realized is ki student bahut zyada bhavuk ho jate hain. For example, jab main investment ka topic padha raha tha, or when I was teaching the topic of financial market, students were very much interested in understanding how to do investment. Investment kaise karte hain, stock market mein invest kaise karte hain, profit kaise kamate hain. These were the questions that were majorly asked by them. It's completely okay to be curious. In saari cheezo ke baare mein curiosity rakhna bahut achhi baat hai. But you have to understand that you have to stick the syllabus, because the syllabus is very, very huge when it comes to finance. Then we have management, then we have ESI, so on and so forth. So try to stick yourself towards the syllabus only. Jitna syllabus mein diya hua hai, utna hi padhne ki koshish kariye. Theek hai? Bahut zyada bahar jaane ki zarurat nahi hai. So this is the broad syllabus. That is the first thing that you have to go through. First segment is financial system, where a lot of topics are going to be there from Indian financial system, from financial markets, so on and so forth. Then you have primary and secondary market and all of these topics. And while you're going through the syllabus, also try and identify what are the topics where you will be needing some amount of current affairs, jahan pe aapko thode current affairs ki zarurat hogi. For example, if you're studying about banking system, to wahan pe repo rate ke andar changes aate rahenge, reverse repo rate ke andar changes aate rahenge. So these changes in rates of interest are important from your exam point of view. And similarly, there are going to be some chapters which are going to be purely static in nature. For example, corporate governance in banking. So whatever has been the guidelines, whatever has been the recommendations of committees, they're going to be majorly same. So the first aspect is that you go through the syllabus very, very thoroughly and you stick to the syllabus. So they are divided into 3 segments. One is the basic topics. The second one is the financial market. And then you have general topics where you have these important topics which you have to cover. So ek baar syllabus bilkul aapko acche se go through kar lena hai. That is going to be the first step. Now, once you have gone through the syllabus, what a lot of students would find is, and this is something that I keep hearing from students, and that is, sir, I'm not from a finance background, and I've not done my MBA, I've not done my MCOM. How can I score better marks or how can I score higher marks? And this is the reaction that I give them. That is, you can clearly see this is a meme from your very recently released movie, that is Animal. So, see, you have to accept this fact that since it is a generalist profile, they are not expecting you to be an expert in the finance subject. What they are only expecting is that you are able to understand the basics, you are able to comprehend basics, and based on that, you are able to give your answer. So, if basic concepts are clear ho rahe hain finance ke, you will be able to score very good marks, provided that you are practicing properly and you are doing proper answer writing. Bahut zyada expert level knowledge ki, bahut zyada technical level knowledge ki zarurat nahi hai if you are not coming from a finance background. It doesn't make much difference. Okay, now, so I have planned in a way where there is a 3-step approach which you can follow to specifically score very high marks. The first aspect is, which I have already told you, is to go through the syllabus. Try to go through the syllabus thoroughly before you start and try to stick to it as much as possible. The second part is past year questions. Past year questions, how are they going to help you? They are going to tell you which topics are important. Of course, I know that the pattern would keep changing. For example, last year, corporate governance se kaafi marks se questions aa gaye the, 10-15 marks ke. There's a very small topic of CSR, corporate social responsibility, in which 5-6 marks question were being asked. But broadly, you will get an idea that which topics have to be focused upon, which topics the questions are coming in a repeated manner. And also the level of the question, kis level ke questions aa rahe hain, kitna zyada depth mein jaane ki zarurat hai, all of those things are going to be spelled by your past year questions only. So try to get hold of them, try to have the level, try to get an idea of what are the type of questions and then proceed further. And the third and the most important aspect is to practice as many mocks as possible. Jitne mocks laga ke chale jaoge, utna zyada beneficial hoga, because you will get a real life exposure, you will get a exam like exposure when you are taking mocks. ठीक है, वहां पे टाइम बाउंड एलिमेंट्स होंगे, सो यू विल गेट अ बेटर प्रैक्टिस, यू विल आल्सो गेट टू रियलाइज अबाउट योर एक्यूरेसी एंड योर ऑथेंटिसिटी. सो देयरफॉर ये तीन एस्पेक्ट्स आपको ध्यान रखने हैं. आई कॉल इट एज थ्री स्टेप अप्रोच. नाउ व्हाट आर गोइंग टू बी द टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस एंड हाउ यू हैव टू टैकल. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस है जो स्टूडेंट के दिमाग में रहता है. सो स्पेसिफिकली इन केसेस ऑफ फाइनेंस वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन, वन इज ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड वन इज डिस्क्रिप्टिव क्वेश्चन. सी, इफ आई टू टॉक अबाउट ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस, इन ऑर्डर टू आंसर दीज ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस, योर concepts have to be very very thorough. Jitne zyada aapke concepts clear honge, the more your concepts are clear, the more thorough you are in terms of your concepts, you will be able to answer. Because agar tukke maroge, if you're doing some kind of guesswork, there is going to be negative marking, you already know that. So the first idea is to get hold of the concepts, understand them in a very beautiful manner, in a very comprehensive manner, and then practice as many MCQs as much as possible. And therefore, after every chapter in the course also, we have provided you with the practice questions. Now you have to talk about descriptive. The very first question that students would often ask is, sir, answer writing practice kab karni hai? How do we start? So first of all, try to understand that till the time you have completed at least 50% of the syllabus, jab tak aapne ek sufficient amount of syllabus cover nahi liya hai, there's no point starting with the answer writing practice, specifically with respect to your descriptive questions. So once you have done 50% of the syllabus or somewhere around 30 to 40% of the syllabus, what you can do is pick up past year papers. Past year papers उठा लीजिए, उसके अंदर जो भी questions given हैं in terms of descriptive, start writing them. You can get evaluated by your seniors, you can get evaluated by your mentors, you can get evaluated by your peers. और अगर इनमें से कोई भी नहीं available है, you can evaluate the answers by yourself. You just have to be clear that what are the parameters that I have to look forward. One parameter is that you have to make sure that you are giving all the pointers. सारे pointers आप अपने answers के अंदर दे रहे हैं. You're giving all the keywords, you're writing as many keywords as much as possible. Okay? And at the very same time, wherever you can give some facts, wherever you can quote some data, for example, repo rate ke bare mein likhna, you have to talk about some other kinds of rates, you're mentioning that. And wherever you can provide examples, wherever you can give examples, for example, let's say the question is on corporate governance theories. So agar wahan pe aap example de sakte ho, try to mention that. These are going to be some parameters which are going to help you evaluate whether you are on the right track or not, whether you are writing your answers in a correct order or not. Okay? These are some things that you have to keep in mind while practicing your descriptive questions. Now, there is also one important element that you have to understand, that your paper or your level or the type of questions are divided into two parts. One is the static finance part and the other one is your current affairs part. क्योंकि फाइनेंस में बहुत सारी ऐसी चीजें हैं विच कीप्स ऑन गेटिंग अपडेटेड. फॉर एग्जांपल एनबीएफसीज के बारे में बात करें, रिसेंटली 4-scale-layer फ्रेमवर्क हैज बीन डिवाइस्ड. सिमिलरली सीबीडीसी इज देयर, डिजिटल करेंसी, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट्स आर कमिंग अप विच आर बीइंग इनिशिएटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट एज वेल एज आरबीआई. सो यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड क्वेश्चंस बोथ फ्रॉम करंट अफेयर सेक्शन एज वेल एज फ्रॉम स्टैटिक पोर्शन. इफ आई टू ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाई, आई वुड प्रोबेबली से अराउंड 35 marks of the weightage is being taken up by your static portion and approximately 15 marks weightage is being taken up by your current affairs. So this is broadly what you have to focus. So aapko aisa nahi karna that you are just focusing on the concepts in terms of static understanding. You also have to make sure that you're going through the current affairs portion, whatever are the recent amendments, whatever are the recent the regulatory changes that are taking place, whatever are the initiatives, ye sari ki sari cheeze bhi aapko cover karni hogi. Now the important question that you must be thinking, sir, where to cover them? Where and how to cover them is an important question. If you are preparing by yourself, let's say aapne is institute ke saath tie up nahi kar rakha, you have not enrolled in any course, you can prepare by yourself also, and that is with the help of Bharti Pathak book of Indian Financial System. Bharti Pathak book aati hai Indian Financial System ki. This is something that you can purchase from the market, and you have to make sure that you do not have to read the entire book. Ek baar book dekhoge to lagega ki bahut moti book hai, you might think that I will not be able to cover, but you have to understand, you do not have to cover the entire book. Only those chapters, only those portions of the syllabus which are mentioned in your syllabus for phase 2, only those chapters you have to cover, but you have to cover in a comprehensive manner that you're understanding each and every concept if you're preparing by yourself. And if I have to talk about current affairs, there are few segments such as RBI website, because us pe regular updates aate rehte hain, live mint ya business standard utha sakte ho to get aware about the finance changes and what are the updates in finance domain. RBI reports also, whatever reports are being issued by RBI, RBI ki annual report ho gayi, theek hai, aur bhi jo bhi important reports aate hain, these have to be covered. If you think that you are not able to follow these things, if you are not able to cover these three elements, you can rely on RBI 247, iske regular sessions hote rehte hain on our YouTube channel. But the PDF is available in the course only. So video, aap free mein cover kar sakte hain. You can go to the YouTube channel and you can cover that. But PDFs are only available in the course. And those are very detailed PDF with a lot of comprehensive notes and pointers. Okay? So this is how you can cover your static portion. And this is these are some of the sources from where you can cover up your current affairs portion. Both the elements are equally important. You should not be having this mindset ki main sirf static karke chala jata hu, mera exam qualify ho jayega. That is not going to happen. Because a lot of times what is being seen in the past year is that in the descriptive questions also, the type of question that are being asked are in such a way that you will have to write some amount of facts there, some amount of schemes there in order to give a beautiful answer. Sirf pointers likhe chale aoge, static portion likhe chale aoge, kuch bhi facts nahi likhoge, you will end up scoring low marks. So in order to get very high marks, you will have to substitute your static answer along with a lot of examples from regulatory schemes, from government schemes, from a lot of changes that have taken place in the economy, in the financial sector. So therefore, both the segments are equally important. Now, these are few last pointers, I would say, few end pointers, I would say, which you have to consistently do if you want to score very high marks, such as 35 plus marks in your finance segment. And what are these? The first part is practice regularly. If you think that you're just watching the video, you're just going through the notes and you will practice the MCQs at the very end, last mein soch rahe ho ki last mein practice kar lunga, it is not going to be helpful. You have to make sure that in terms of MCQs, you have to talk about in terms of the multiple choice questions. Once you are done with a chapter, once you're complete with one chapter, let's say, try to solve as many questions as much as possible. Jitne questions MCQs laga loge, utna zyada acha hoga, utni zyada aapki practice ho jayegi. More diverse set of questions you are practicing, better you are prepared for your examination. So that is the first thing. Second thing is revision. For example, the syllabus is very huge. For example, there are approximately 14-15 chapters, if I leave accountancy aside, 14-15 chapters which are specifically there in finance section. Then there are 3-4 sections, 3-4 chapters in accountancy also. So now approximately 18-19 chapters are there. Now let's say if you have covered the first chapter of regulatory body in, let's say, in the month of September. And now for the next 3 months, that is September, October, November, you have not touched those chapters. Aapne un chapter ko utha ke nahi dekha ek bar bhi. I am very sure you will end up forgetting 80% of the things. So the broad idea is that utilize your weekends well. Your weekdays you are having the classes, or let's say on your weekdays you are spending a lot of time in going through these videos, if you are studying from various notes or whatever material you have, utilize your weekends for revision portion. Try to revise as many topics, as many videos as much as possible, and specifically those which you have studied at the very earliest stage. For example, agar aapne September mein regulatory body padha hai, so koshish kariye second week mein, fourth week mein, and so on and so forth. We can have a separate video for how to revise. You keep revising these videos, you keep revising these concepts. Otherwise, you will end up forgetting everything. Okay? And the third part is answer writing. As I just told you, once you have done with 50% of the syllabus, let's say 30-40% syllabus khatam ho gaya hai, start with the answer writing immediately. Because answer writing is not something that you can develop over a day. Ek din ke andar answer writing mein expert nahi ban jaoge. The more you practice, the more better you are going to become in terms of your answer writing. So, jitna zyada practice kar loge, utna zyada aapki answer writing achhi ho jayegi. Theek hai? So, these are few last minute elements that I would say which you have to do consistently if you want to score very high marks. Okay. Now, we already have the course running for 2024. So, if you want to enroll, you can visit our website www.anujindal.in. You can also call us on the number. This is the contact number 9999-466-225. This is the contact number. You can speak to our counselors and you can get enrolled in the course. We are also having special mentorship sessions jo ki Saturday ko hote hain, those are currently running up, in which we try to help students, we try to guide students with whatever problem they are facing. They are amazing, they're helping students to a very large extent. So if you want, you can keep attending that also. And also, these are some of our toppers from the previous batches that clearly tells us that how rigorously we have been training our students who are being enrolled with us. So that's all about today's video. If you think that you have learned something new, please hit the like button. Do subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, if you have any queries, you can put it in the comment section. Thank you. God bless you. Keep preparing well. See you all in the class. Thank you.